10-6, trigonometric ratios. A trigonometric ratio is a ratio of the side lengths of a right triangle. You may have heard of these before. Sine, cosine, and tangent are what we are going to be looking at. Here, we have the basic trigonometric ratios. We have our hypotenuse, our adjacent side to B, and our opposite side of B. Now, to find the sine of B, we are going to take the opposite over the hypotenuse. For the cosine of B, it's going to be the adjacent over the hypotenuse. And then tan would be the opposite over the adjacent, which is also known as sine over cosine. Now, you can remember that adjacent is going to be next to, so whichever angle you have, your adjacent is going to be what's next to it. And then the opposite is going to be the one that is opposite of it, across the triangle from it. And that is how you might be able to remember this. Okay, now we're going to look at finding some trigonometric ratios. What are sine of A, cosine of A, and tan of A? So we're going to look at this triangle that we're given. And we're going to find sine, cosine, and tangent. So first, let's find sine. So we're going to look for the opposite over the hypotenuse. So if we're looking at angle A, the opposite side is going to be 15, and the hypotenuse is 17. So we're going to get 15 over 17. Next, we're going to look for the cosine of A. Cosine is going to be the adjacent over the hypotenuse, so it will be 8 over 17. And finally, to find the tangent, we're going to use the opposite leg and put it over the adjacent leg. So we're going to have 15 over 8. And you can leave it just like this. We don't want to put it into any decimals. We're just going to leave it as a ratio, as is. Now, I want you to find, using this triangle, the sine of angle E, the cosine of angle E, and the tangent of angle E. Now bring these answers to class and we will discuss them. The next thing I'm going to show you how to do is find a ratio with your calculator. So, we're going to find what is the value of cosine of 55 degrees to the nearest 10,000th. Okay, so we are going to do this by typing into our calculator. We're going to type in cosine, then we're going to put 55 for our 55 degrees, and you have to make sure you have a parenthesis on the other side, because if it's not enclosed, you're not going to get the correct answer. So make sure that you have a parenthesis, so when it's finished, it has cosine and then 55 in parentheses. And then when you hit enter, you will get a decimal, so you should end up with cosine of 55 degrees being approximately 0.5736. Now I would like you to do the following on your calculator and bring them to class. The next part that you are going to look at doing is finding a missing side length of a triangle. So, we're going to look at this triangle here where we know side X and we know side the hypotenuse is 14 and we know that one of the angles is 48 degrees. Now, we want to find the length of X, so we're going to use what we know to figure that out. So, what is the value of X? Now, since we know that X is opposite of 48 degrees, we know that the sine of 48 degrees is going to be equal to X over 14, because that is the definition of sine. So we're going to set sine of 48 degrees equal to opposite over hypotenuse, so x over 14. And now we're going to use our algebra rules to solve this. So to undo our division, we're going to, of course, multiply by 14 on each side. And so we'll get x equals 14 times the sine of 48 degrees. And then when we type that into our calculator, we will get that x is approximately 10.4042756. And then we want to round to the nearest tenth, so we will get 10.4. So x is about 10.4 when we use this strategy. Now I want you to use this triangle given here and find the length of x to the nearest tenth. I started it for you. Alright, the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to find the measures of some different angles. For this, we're going to use what I have listed here, which is sine to the negative 1, cosine to the negative 1, and tan to the negative 1. Now, we don't really read that as to the negative 1. Instead, we read that as the inverse of sine, the inverse of cosine, and the inverse of tangent. We will use these inverses to find missing angles. So using this triangle at the right, what are the angle measures? Step one, we know that adjacent and a hypotenuse of angle A. So we're going to use cosine. And we know that because if we have the adjacent and hypotenuse, that will give us the cosine. So we're going to use cosine. So now we're going to have to write our equation. So we're going to have the cosine of A equals 12 over 24. So the cosine of A equals 0.5. And now we're going to set that equal to the measure of A. So the measure of A is going to equal the inverse cosine of 0.5 because we're working backwards, so we're using the inverse. So angle A is 60 degrees. Now to find angle B, we need to use our triangle rules. We know it's a right triangle, and we know that a triangle measures 180 degrees total. So we're going to take 180, subtract the 60 that we just found for angle A, and then we're also going to subtract 90 for the right angle that we know of, and we find out that our angle that we're missing is going to be 30 degrees. And it's actually angle C on this drawing. I accidentally wrote angle B, so disregard that. It's angle C that we're finding is 30 degrees. In a right triangle, the side opposite of angle A is 8 millimeters long, and the hypotenuse is 12 millimeters long. What is the measure of angle A? Now you're going to use the inverses like we just learned, and then please bring your answer to class for this. Alright, the next thing we're going to look at is an angle of elevation and an angle of depression. So an angle of elevation is an angle from the horizontal up to a line of sight. And the angle of depression is an angle from the horizon down to a line of sight. Now I'm going to pull a picture to give you a visual for this. So, if we have a hot air balloon and we have a person looking at it, we have our angle of depression shown with that red bracket, And that angle right there would be our angle of depression because it's going downward. And then the line through the middle, which is going to act as a hypotenuse in our triangle, is our line of sight because we're looking up to the air balloon or looking down to the person. And then the positive angle is going to be our angle of elevation, where's the other red bracket is down by the person. So now we're going to use this to solve a problem. All right. So, if we are using this picture here, now, we are going to look at using angles of elevation and depression to answer some questions about this ride. As you can see, this ride is 150 feet tall. You are going to be waiting in line. And your friend is at the top of the ride. How far are you from the base of this ride? Okay, so we're going to look at this. And the ride has a height of 150 feet. Now, the angle of depression is 20 degrees. And the angle of elevation is also 20 degrees. Now, we want to find the distance from where you're standing to the base of the ride, so we're trying to find x. Now, we know the adjacent to x, but we do not know the hypotenuse. But we are trying to find x, which would technically be the other one. So we're going to use tan. So we're going to set this up, and we're going to use tangent. So we're going to have tangent of 20 degrees is opposite over adjacent. So it's 150 over x. Adjacent, I'm sorry, that's the word I was looking for. So we have 150 degrees over x for our tangent. Now we'll use our algebra skills and we'll multiply both sides by x. So we'll have x times the tangent of 20 equals 150. And now we're going to divide both sides by tangent of 20 to get our x by itself. So then when we do that, x is approximately 412.1216129. And we want to round to the nearest 10 feet. So 410 feet to the nearest, 410 feet to the base of the ride.